particular video, we're going to show you how to infinite clone an object using the object drop down menu. For this particular example, we want the student to drag the coin to its correct value. In order to do this, we want the coin to stay in the piggy bank. However, we do want the student to drag a coin to its correct name and value. So to do this, we set up an infinite cloner. To set up an infinite cloner, right click on the object, choose infinite clone. You'll know an object is infinite clone if you select it again and you'll see an infinity sign in the upper right hand corner. This allows the student to drag an object wherever they desire. To undo infinite clone, simply right click the object and check infinite cloner. This will undo the infinite clone that you had set up. To continue with infinite clone, we're going to set up a page in order for students to count and write the amount of money in the particular square. We'll show you also how to manipulate objects and change properties in this particular video. First thing I'm going to do is create a single rectangle with a line and a cent sign for students to write in answers. And I want to clone this particular object several times so I don't have to remake it. Since I made it the first time, I'm going to select both objects and I'm going to group them. Once I've grouped them, I can infinite clone and place them in the four parts of my page. Now I'm simply going to copy coins that I've made on another page and paste the coins so that the student can count and write the amount. What I want to do next is I want to make sure I lock down the objects so that the students cannot manipulate or alter them in some way, shape, or form. To do that, right click, choose locking, lock in place. Now you have a short little activity that's going to engage students by counting and writing the value.